We are from the Gerber Street in Weimar, a cultural project as well as a housing project. 11 years ago, we made the embankment of the Buchenwald Railway walkable and created a place to commemorate about 2,000 children who were deported from Buchenwald to extermination camps. The Buchenwald Railway was officially inaugurated on June 21, 1943 by the SS. It was constructed in only 3 months. Up to 1,100 inmates worked daily on the construction site. Each third inmate lost his life. In only 3 weeks, the embankment was filled. The inmates loaded the soil on lorries and carted it here.
We are here in the restoration workshop of the Buchenwald Memorial. We collect and restore archaeological objects found on the site of the memorial. The objects arrive here in the restoration workshops, are registered, documented and preserved. Our utmost concern is to conserve the objects, but it's also about getting more information.
Es geht auch darum, einfach mehr an Informationen zu bekommen.
Diese Gedenksteine.
These stones commemorate the boys who have been deported from Buchenwald to Auschwitz on September 25, 1944. Except for one, Alfred Rosenbach, all others lost their lives.
Our aim is to commemorate each of these children with a stone.
Sinti and Roma were brought here. The boys and men were destined for working in another concentration camp, the concentration camp Dora. Und 300 stayed here, mainly children and adolescents. For 200 out of these 300, the SS had no usage. They were not capable of working here. Therefore, the SS decided to send them back to Auschwitz, where they would be gassed. These are the names of those 200 Sinti and Roma boys who were sent back to Auschwitz.
Die nach Auschwitz zum Vergasen wieder zurücktransportiert worden. Von den 200
Two out of 200 are said to have survived. 198 were killed.
Wir werden jetzt so machen, dass wir zuerst mal hier im Schweigen sitzen.
We will begin by sitting in silence. Then there will be a walking meditation. Everybody will get a sheet of paper. On it is written the family name, the given name, the date of birth and the place of birth. I prefer that you read the given name first and then the family name. That will make it sound less bureaucratic.
Alfred Rosenbach, Hermann Rosenberg, Werner Rosenberg,
Albert Weiß, Willi Weiß, Rudolf Weiß, Josef Winter,
Maximilian Adler,
Leopold Winter,
Ewald Anton,
Rudi Winter,
Erich Balke,
Matthias Winterstein,
Walter Bamberger,
Robert Böhmer,
Otto
Rudolf
Bamberger,
Böhmer, Alfred Brandt,
Wilhelm Becker,
Josef Brandt,
Max Kokulosch,
Kurt Braschke,
Rudolf Köpfe,
Ewald Braun,
Otto Krause, Fred Uberti Krause, Bernhard Krause,
Anton Kreitz,
Herbert Krause,
Rudolf Krenz,
Richard Bruschinski,
Theodor Kreuz,
Ludwig Bruschinski,
Alfred Christoph,
Paul Bruschinski,
Heinrich Laubinger,
Bruschinski,
Arthur Dambrowski,
Adam Bruschinski,
Waldemar
Franz Burek,
Waldemar
Eduard Bujanski,
Jan Wistuchewski, Siegfried Kohl,
Ewald Reinhardt,
Hedwig
Pomé, Gottlieb
Richard
Richter,
Laubinger,
Schubert,
Eduard Laubinger, Gottfried
Berthold
Laubinger,
Rose,
Alfred
Leopold
Laubinger,
Rose.
Mögen die Verdienste unserer Praxis sich auf alle Wesen an allen Orten ausdehnen, insbesondere auf die Kinder, deren Namen gelesen wurden. Mögen sie gemeinsam mit allen lebenden Wesen das wirkliche Glück finden.
Joy and sorrow, I make it mine.
in den 10 Richtungen. Einheit mit der Sangha in den 10 Richtungen. Jetzt habe ich den Bodhi-Geist erweckt.
Ich bin die Buddhas und sie sind ich.
Dies ist das Leben, die Dauer unserer Tage. Tag und Nacht meditieren wir darüber.
In 1996, the American Zen master Bernie Glassman decided to take Zen meditation out of the protected space of a meditation hall and bring it to places where suffering has manifested. He made a first retreat in Auschwitz. In the following years, we searched a place in Germany where we could practice Zazen outside of a meditation hall, and we decided to go to Weimar-Buchenwald.
Our practice is to regularly sit Zazen in a dojo in Solingen. That's what Heinz Jürgen called a protected space.
In einem Dojo hier in Solingen und
we felt the necessity to bring our practice, the essence of our practice, the sitting, but also the action that results of it, to the outside.
Aber auch das Handeln, was daraus entsteht. Wie können wir das nach außen tragen?
The question was, how can we connect our practice with being socially engaged? After the experience we had with the retreats at Auschwitz, it was clear to us we wanted to go to places of suffering to practice Zazen.
During the session in Buchenwald, we sit Zazen 3 times a day. We sit in silence. The silence allows us again and again to look inwards. Usually, when you visit a memorial of a concentration camp, you get a guided tour that gives you a lot of information. You look always to the outside. Of course, we also look to the outside during the days, but 3 times a day we turn the gaze inward. In the outside, we work at different places within the former camp. We grapple with the place with our bodies, not only on a mental level. We conduct ceremonies at different places to live the spiritual dimension of our practice at a place that is marked by enormous suffering.
An einem Ort zu leben, der durch enormes Leid gekennzeichnet ist.
Aber auch mit diesem ganzen Wissen.
We have grown up with information about National Socialism. We have acquired knowledge about Buchenwald itself. But it is nevertheless our practice to let go of all concepts, all judgments, all opinions in our practice of Zazen.
Durch oder in unserer Zazen-Praxis fallen lassen. Es geht also darum.
The point is to open our mind as far as possible for that which is happening just now. It's not only about the suffering that has happened back then, but also about the suffering that manifests today inside and outside of us. That can connect itself when we let go of the history and the concepts that are already in our head.
Knowledge always comes from the past. In Zen, we enter not knowing, because not knowing is what really exists in the moment. In the session, we establish a contact with what really is with the reality on the spot, the reality in Buchenwald.
Mögen die Verdienste unserer Praxis sich auf alle Wesen an allen Orten ausdehnen.
Meier Goldschmidt, Emil Goldschmied, Kurt Goldstein, Julius Gonsenhäuser,
Bernhard Moritz Meier, Sigmund Oskar Meier,
Aaron Stern, Benno Stern, Ferdinand Stern,
Julius Ascher, Dr. Heinrich Aschkowitz, Hermann Herz-Bacharach,
Ludwig Fuchs, Leopold Fuld, Josef Gassenheimer.
Als ich diesen Vortrag
When I decided to give this talk here in Buchenwald, it was clear to me that its subject had to be why it is so important to practice here. Our practice experience today, here and now, is possible for us only by the transmission of the practice, by the preservation and repetition of the practice of the Buddhas and ancestors. And in reverse, the practice of the Buddhas and the ancestors is actualized by us here today and now. This is what the circle of the way, the circle of the practice means. The practice without any interruption. Our practice here in Buchenwald is a part of this circle as well, because we actualize moment after moment the pure practice of the Buddhas and ancestors. When we sit in Zazen, we always go back to concentrate on the posture and the perception of our breathing. We are aware of the thoughts and feelings which emerge, but we do not follow them. In this way, we are one with each moment. We are wide awake, completely attentive. We are content with being completely in this moment, without adding anything, without rejecting anything. When we practice with such attention, no painful words, thoughts, or actions can arise. In a place like Buchenwald, where so much pain was produced by words, thoughts and actions, Shikantaza is a practice of a great help. But also the fact of taking the meals together, the ceremonies, the recitation, the prostration, the work with the barrows on the commemorative path and in the restoration workshop, the listening to others in the circle in which we share our experiences, the reading of the names of the victims, all this becomes Shikan. Shikan Mie, Shikan recitation, Shikan work, Shikan being. Simply that. During the Zeshin in Buchenwald, we practice that together and are in harmony with the other participants moment by moment. All the phenomena which come to us during these days are opportunities to practice simply that, without attachment, without rejection. Exactly in a place like this one, which is not a neutral place or a protective place like a dojo, it is important during Zazen and all the other practices not to be taken by thoughts or feelings. This doesn't mean that thoughts or emotions are forbidden to emerge in this place. We are aware of them, but we do not cling to them. As here in Buchenwald, many thoughts and strong feelings can arise than during other Zeshins. We gather every evening to listen to one another. It is clear that in this place exchange is especially necessary. But also, during these meetings, we practice Mushotoku and Ishirio. We practice pure listening. Of course, it is difficult to pursue the Zen practice within the framework of social relationships and in an environment which is based on differences, illusions, and the search for profit. But it is exactly there that our practice is most needed. It is where suffering arises that we have to find the appropriate means to act against it. The practice cannot depend on place or time. If we really preserve the pure practice, we practice independently of place and time. Everything is a field for practice, and all the phenomena are gates of Dharma that have to be penetrated, as it is expressed in the third Bodhisattva vow. In this way, Buchenwald became the place of our practice. In places of suffering, we put ourselves in situations which go beyond our imagination. We can only let go of our concepts and our ideas to be completely present. Buddha Shakyamuni also left his palace. He faced old age, disease and death, and it overtook his imagination. He decided to find a way to go beyond suffering. Without this concrete contact with the world of suffering, he would not have ventured out. Buchenwald is for 4 days our dojo, the practice place where the Gyoji of the Buddhas and ancestors is continued. But every place can be a practice place. The whole world can be our monastery. May our practice here in Buchenwald contribute to the liberation of all beings, everywhere and any times.
That's the only photo that's allowed to wave.
We also could bow together.
Okay.
One, two, three.